Few places are more awe-inspiring than this magnificent Inca city perched on top of a mountain ridge in the Andes of South America. We make our way to Machu Picchu and stroll through this magical place. We fly into Cusco, the ancient capital of the Incan Empire, residing on a dry plateau at 11,000 feet. Machu Picchu sits at a lower 8,000 feet. We take the train to the town of Agua Caliente at the base of Machu Picchu, where a bus takes us up the mountain. The train ride to Machu Picchu is spectacular along the river with beautiful scenic views.
Final destination is Machu Picchu Station.
The more adventurous can take a 4-day Inca trail hike to Machu Picchu, starting across the river here near those huts. The Urubamba River flows past the base of Machu Picchu and continues to the Amazon River. These girls got off to take a shorter 1-day hike to Machu Picchu and they'll head across that bridge. The landscape is very lush as we are now in a tropical mountain climate.
The end of our journey.
The first leg of our walk is the length of Machu Picchu on a lower path. The city of Machu Picchu resides on a saddle between two mountain peaks. The largest, called Machu Picchu, means old mountain, and the smaller, more vertical peak is called Huayna Picchu, meaning young mountain. Just behind us here is where the Inca Trail crests over the mountain. On that ridge sits the Sun Temple, where hikers on the trail see Machu Picchu for the first time. Incan Emperor Pachacuti built Machu Picchu as an estate for the high social class around 1450. It was abandoned about 100 years later with the Spanish conquest of the Inca Empire. Fortunately, the conquistadors never found it, or it would have been largely destroyed. Centuries went by, the forest gradually grew over it, and it was forgotten, except by local farmers. The condor was a sacred bird to the Incas. They believed it had a special connection to the gods. We come to the Temple of the Condor, making use of a rock formation to represent the bird.
Look at the eyes, the bill, and the white collar. This is part of the body, and this is the wings.
Machu Picchu's location high up on the mountain provided protection, with the added benefit of being closer to their gods. The large terraced areas were for growing crops.
Yeah, I think I'll stay away from there too.
Chilopu.
And it had two urban districts, a lower area for workers and an upper area for nobility, which included sacred sites. Overall, it had 216 buildings and was estimated to have had 800 to 1,000 people living here. From here, we can see people making the trek up Huayna Picchu. The ruins at the top are believed to have been the residence of the high priest. Only 400 people a day are allowed to make the ascent. And it takes about 1 hour to climb, and it's very difficult and scary with steep sections. Our guide said about every 3 years someone dies attempting the climb. Definitely for the fit and fearless. Certainly not me. It does have a magnificent view of Machu Picchu from the top.
Here's the entry to Huayna Picchu Trail.
We arrive at the sacred rock and notice that it's the shape of a guinea pig with the head on the right. It's believed that sacred rituals were performed here, and the entrance to the Huayna Picchu Trail is where the high priest would come and go. We now make our way back through the middle of Machu Picchu and climb up to its famous panoramic viewpoint. Machu Picchu was brought to the world's attention by Hiram Bingham, a historian working at Yale University. On an expedition in 1911, he was led to the site by a local farmer and his son. Bingham organized funding from Yale and National Geographic, and with the support of the Peruvian president, he spent the next 3 years clearing the site. He discovered tombs with mummies, ceramics, and other antiquities, all which went to Yale University. Bingham called this place the Lost City of the Incas, and National Geographic devoted their April 1913 issue to Machu Picchu, giving it much publicity. In 2012, the artifacts were sent back to Peru, and you can now see them at a museum in Cusco.
Nicely cut those stones there. And up top is going to be the postcard view.
We come to the royal tomb where they believe mummies were kept, although none were found here. And the tower up top is the Temple of the Sun. The two windows are aligned to the summer and winter solstices.
Every place is a good view.
Here is the guardhouse, which was used by soldiers who guarded the entrance to Machu Picchu from the Inca Trail. And it's also the best vantage point, which everyone wants to see.
The view continues. Awesome sight. Another part of the river way down here.
Our last leg through Machu Picchu is through its western high elevation. Standing on the highest elevation of Machu Picchu is the Intihuatana Stone. The stone's four sides are cardinal points for north, south, east, and west. And the needle is tilted 13 degrees to cast no shadow on the spring and fall equinoxes when the sun is directly above the equator. The Spanish conquistadors made a point of breaking these off whenever they found them. And because the stone has been damaged with a large crack, a guard watches to ensure that no one touches it. Without a doubt, no other place is more identified with the Inca world than Machu Picchu. And no other place is more mystical or fascinating, earning it the title of one of the new Seven Wonders of the World. If you enjoy my videos, I encourage you to subscribe by clicking on my YouTube channel icon. It's free, and sharing with your friends is much appreciated. You can play another video by clicking a thumbnail on the right, and you could also find my videos by searching for Haswell Traveled on YouTube or Google.